Yes, class 10th D. So today two parts we are going to revise of the chapter, two stories about flying. If I see any disturbance, that child will continue because we have already done the chapter, we have revised it also. This is the second revision going on now and still you people are so casual. No commenting, please. You are not sitting here as commentator. So, note down the points. First part is his first flight. His here is used for the seagull. They are basically known as the water birds residing near the area of the sea. And basically, they dive at the sight of the fish. Whenever they see fish in the sea, they can jump at any time. And while flight, only while the movement of flying only, they catch their prey. If I stop in between, it means there is some disturbance and that child has to go outside. Yes, last second boy, to whom you are serving in the class? And the one who will speak the name is also will be accompanying. Poor attitude. So seagull is too young. It has not started flying yet. Parents of the seagull, stand up. Stand up. Yes, you. So they are trying to perfect siblings of the seagull. Every person is different. The way human beings are different, same case goes with, wait, let me handle you first and then I will not continue. I'm going to pause it first. So now when two, three boys are out of the class, that will be better. I have to name it in the recording also, those who are standing then. So we were discussing young seagull, the story of determination and hard work and efforts that is visible in this first part, that you have to keep on trying and trying until and unless you are succeeded. You should not give up, never give up. That is the theme of the story. Fine. So young seagull afraid to fly. Everybody has one phobias, aversions in life. What is the aversion and phobia of the seagull is? It thinks that when it will try to fly, he might fall. So he's not trying. Fine. Parents perfecting siblings of seagull. But this seagull, young seagull is not at all following brother sister. Then mothers, you know, they know their kids better. So, I was discussing that mothers, they know their kids better. Mother Seagull, she thought that I should do something to, you know, make my child fly. So, she knows that how important that particular food is for my child. They, in front of the baby seagull or young seagull, they started catching the preys. P-R-E-Y, prey. And they catch the fish in front of the baby seagull. And he was, and they also, they left young seagull on the ledge when it was not flying. And they started, she started showing the fish, which was favorite food of this young seagull. Number one, already it was hungry. Clear? And secondly, it got maddened by the hunger. It jumped. And when it jumped by at the sight of the fish, that young seagull forgot that he did not know how to fly. So what do we learn out of this situation? Anyone? What do we learn? That sometimes we ourselves are not aware of our own caliber. Others know you better. Your parents and teachers, if they say something to you, even you are not aware of your caliber. So he was not aware that I can fly unless and until mother showed food to it. Fine. So when that fish was shown, it dived in out of hunger and made his first flight successfully. So that is there in the story. But actually, hunger, sometimes punishment given to us is a blessing so that we learn not to repeat it in the future. So here hunger has proved the path of, show it to me, what are you writing? Give your notebook to me. Fine. So, I know. So, the theme of the story is that so it is a story of hesitation. When you hesitate to do something, it is a story of trial and error. Try karo, mistakes hoengi, phir try karo, phir mistakes hoengi, but keep on doing it unless and until you become perfect in that. So, it is a story of hesitation, story of making trials, story of committing errors, and finally becoming successful out of hard work and determination. Fine. So his two brothers, how many siblings? They were two brothers and one sister. So they already learned to fly, art of flying. After a bad start, finally this young seagull learned to fly, and after repeated trials, it became successful in its venture. So please stand up. Yes, you. Stand up. And keep on standing. Bahar hi aajao. Because you are the kind of person who will stand and even then you will speak. Next is second part. I'll be asking questions more. I'm not now because we have done revision many times. So only layout of the chapter or the main points. Write down part 2, the black aeroplane. Write down, jaldi se. The black aeroplane. So in this, a unique and mysterious experience is mentioned. You note down the points. I won't be writing because when I start writing, you will start talking. So write down. Narrator has mentioned a unique experience. Narrator has mentioned a unique experience during his flight from Paris to London. You can get a question from where to where he was going, when you should know. Narrator's experience of moving from Paris to London. Clear? And why it was unique, he's going to discuss that. On his, so now next point is, and basically he was moving to England, on his way to England. On his way to England. Firstly, write down the points, then I'll explain to you. Stormy clouds. All instruments dead, girls, aapki awaaz bhi aa rahi hai. sight of the black aeroplane. Sight, S-I-G-H-T. Sight of the black aeroplane. बैठ जाओ, बैठ के बातें कर लो. Sight of the black aeroplane. After instruments dead, next point is sight of the black aeroplane. Sit down, last boy. Sit down. There only. उधर ही बैठ जाओ. Narrator landed safely. Yes, you stand up and go there. One should occupy the seat. Narrator landed safely. And last point is, and the very important point is, mystery about the black aeroplane. Mystery about the black aeroplane. So in this story, the black aeroplane, who is the narrator? Anybody can name him? Frederick Forsyth. Yes, Frederick Forsyth is the narrator of this story. See how well read you people are. Anything. So, which plane was being flown by the narrator? Which plane? Yes, the Kota plane. Good. Though you have read it there, even then it's good because at least you are trying to give the answer. So, well done, Daks. Moon was coming in the clear sky when narrator started his journey. Vivan, sit down. Sky was clear, moon was shining. So basically, whenever any air travel is to be there, then they check the weather firstly. So narrator also was aware that today the weather was clear that day. And the Kota aeroplane over France back to England, he has to go. He contacted Paris control for the instructions. So there are control rooms from where they get instructions. He contacted Paris control to get the instructions. But listen, you will get a benefit. No one else. He was asked to turn 12 degrees west. Isko likh lo, 12 degrees west. In the instructions from the control room of Paris, he got the instructions to move to 12 degrees from west. He thought that he would be, you know, well in time, he will be reaching and he will enjoy his English breakfast with his family over there. But, you know, things are different. What we plan is never happening, or sometimes it is changed also. Yeah. So stormy clouds were waiting for him. Yeah. Paris was, abhi kitna bada tha? 150 kilometers. 150 kilometers away, and he saw the clouds in the sky. They were like stormy clouds, not you can say the normal ones, and they were quite black in color, as if he was seeing the black mountains in front of him. Clear? So they were very black in color, the way we see black mountains. Aise lag raha tha. So he could not avoid flying over them. He could not change his path because he was getting instructions already. He has to move. And he did not have enough petrol to fly around that he could change his path or he could think of any other way. Limited petrol was there. Fuel, you can say. He thought of going back to Paris. Firstly, he had this idea in mind that I should change my plan. I should go back to Paris. Fine, that was the first thing which came to his mind. But when you see that your family is waiting, you have to enjoy your breakfast with them. That imaginary scene, you know, he had again, that vision. He could not stop himself of flying or changing his decision. So he thought, I should fly only and I should give it a try. Maybe I will be reaching well in time. He took the risk. So what did the narrator decide? He decided to take the risk. He flew that old Dakota straight into the storm he entered. Though he knew that they are quite stormy clouds, but even then he entered into the clouds. Everything was suddenly black. Out of the window when he used to see black. No vision. Nothing was clear. Thank you. You are writing for me. Thank you. Everything was suddenly black. He could not see anything. Then he thought I should look at the compass. What is the purpose of compass? Yes. To give the directions. He thought I should look at the compass, but compass was dead. It was not working. So suddenly he started noticing down. Other instruments were also dead. Clear? So he was in a very helpless situation. Fine. And finally, when he was losing hope, he saw a black aeroplane emerging out of the black clouds from nowhere he did not know. And that is the most, you can say, mysterious thing of this chapter. A black aeroplane coming out of the black clouds. Fine. He saw another aeroplane. It was flying next to him. He could see the pilot's face even. And he was glad to see. And that person, he gave him instructions, follow me. And without uttering a word, narrator started following him. He was waving with one hand. The narrator followed him just like an obedient child. Both of them are the children. So when he followed the black aeroplane for almost half an hour, it was half an hour almost, he landed safely and he saw two straight lines of flights before him. He reached the runway path. It was the airport. He cried with joy. And he turned to look for his friend. He thought I should look at that another aeroplane, the black aeroplane and the pilot of that plane. Especially I should be thankful to him. He turned to look for his friend in the black aeroplane, but sky was empty. There was nothing. No sign of plane. He wanted to say thank you to that person who came to his rescue, but no one was found. So that is the mystery. After landing, he went straight. Where did he go straight? To the control tower of that fine airport where he landed. He asked the lady who was there at that airport. He also asked the other pilot was, which plane was there at the same time. But she was so, she gazed at him in a strange way, with a strange look. And she was the one who informed him that there is no another plane on the radar who helped the narrator to arrive there safely. And he was shocked that he was running out of fuel. Compass was dead. Black plane was visible to him. He waved at him. He could see the face of the pilot. He reached safely. But when he asked the lady over there at the control tower of the or the reception maybe of the same airport, he could not get any particular answer. There was no plane over there because weather was not allowing any plane to fly that day. And the answer remained unanswered only. Question remained unanswered. He was in a deep shock. What happened exactly? whether it was his imagination or it was a real thing or God helped him or any supernatural power, nothing is known to anyone. So there the chapter ends. Clear? It is not clear to us even that who helped that pilot that time. Who helped the narrator? Clear? So now your turn to answer the questions. Nahi beta abhi. Your question is, another aeroplane, one extract beta. Jitne bhi sample papers hain, basically they have this part 2 ke upar bahut questions milenge aapko. Why? Reason, there are a lot of facts in this. In this, so you have just one story is there and Seagull was not able to fly and all. But on this part, you have, it doesn't mean that you will not read it. Yes, you have to read each and every chapter thoroughly. But I'm saying, if you want to get factual questions, reasoning wale questions, then this part is going to serve your purpose. So we will discuss question answers tomorrow.